Perhaps I might begin by telling you a little bit about the Adjudication Committee. We're a group of seven, comprising lay members and members of the Fundraising Regulator Board, and our expertise purportedly covers professional fundraising, regulation, and, dare I say it, the law. What have we been up to? A number of things. First, we promulgated our terms of reference and our complaints regime. I'd like to think they're drafted in a user-friendly and non-technical way. We haven't yet heard people say that they're not, but if you've got any concerns about opacity or ambiguity or stuff simply being unclear, please do let us know. We do want to have a dialogue about all this stuff. Is there any complainants in the room? You have my word. If you make a complaint, we're going to entertain it, but you will understand that we will give priority to cases that, as the slide says, give rise to significant public concern or which otherwise have a form of systemic implication. One change from the past: we're enforcing a regime of what the lawyers would call domestic exhaustion. That means try and sort it out for yourselves to begin with, and that seems to be working very well. Complainants do ask for us to take up the cudgels direct, and we tell them that we don't exist to do that, that in the first instance they've got to make all reasonable efforts to sort out their differences with the respondent charity. From time to time, much less often, perhaps because the complainant has previous with a particular charity, charities ask us to step in earlier than we would like. The system's settling down, and I'm pleased to say that many, many complaints are being disposed of at this stage, which seems to me good for the sector, good for the complainant, and good for the respondent charities. And this process is consistent with the practice adopted in other regulatory areas. I hope we haven't got anything wrong over the last year, but if we have, we've established a system for external review. John Wigmore has been appointed, who's already discharged that role in other capacities, so there's a route up to him. If we've badly screwed up the process or come to a decision that might technically be described as bonkers, so that option exists also. We've been working hard. We've dealt with over 600 complaints, published summaries of 8 investigations, and had 1 adjudication. And let me very quickly drill down and speak to, at any moment in time, around 100 that are open, averaging 79 a month. That's about 4 new cases a day. So I regard that as quite a substantial and dynamic book of business. Quite a few complaints, not within our remit, out of scope. That's good, that's bad. It's good that our launch had a sufficiently high profile as to drive people to us. Plainly, if that situation were to obtain for years into the future, it would not be good. Our communication would not be clear enough, and I would hope to bear down on that number in the course of this year, so that the excellent investigations team led by Sarah Fox can concentrate on the work of casework and adjudication. We haven't yet embarked on any own volition or proactive inquiries we ourselves have initiated. That's something the committee very much has in mind, and depending on capacity and workload, it's something that I think we'll give serious attention to in the coming year. As I said, cases that otherwise aren't disposed of between the parties direct may go to investigation. Complainants still not happy, and we consider the case fit for investigation, not necessarily the same thing. We've eight published decisions. Summaries are on the website. Three bullets at the bottom give some examples of the substantive area of concern in each case. One about street fundraising, one about the funding preference scenario that you'll hear about later, and then a third about supervision of third-party agencies. No surprise that that's a generic reference to the Neatfeet case. The whole of the adjudication is up on the website. A matter will go to adjudication by escalation if, as I said at the outset, there are multiple complaints about the same charity or the same set of facts, or there are systemic issues, and we felt Neatfeet came within that rubric. I'm very pleased to say that our findings were accepted by all the charities involved, and what's more, that they've been punctilious in complying with the recommendations that we made in the wake of that decision. We're very conscious that our job as the Adjudication Committee is to police and enforce the code of fundraising practice. Our investigations will from time to time throw up issues as regards the scope of the protection offered by the code, and to that extent we liaise very closely with our Standards Committee, and you're now going to hear from its chair, Suzanne McCarthy.